John Bowlby's decades of work into parent-child attachment has led to a huge body of research into bonds and relationships. Now, an attachment can be described as a long-enduring emotional tie to a specific person. And according to Bowlby, such bonds are rooted in evolutionary development. Now, babies have an innate drive to form an attachment with a primary caregiver. It's pretty sharpish, and that's so they can guarantee someone a little bit bigger and a lot of bit stronger is there for them to protect them from danger. Now, Bowlby suggests that there are five key innate behaviours that babies have in their arsenal straight out of the belly to secure them this satisfactorily whipped primary caregiver. Now, if you watched last time's video, you'll know that these behaviours are sucking, cuddling, looking, smiling, and crying. S-C-L-S-C. So how does an attachment develop? Well, Bowlby identifies four stages. The first phase, called pre-attachment, covers the first 2 months from birth. In this time, babies already show a portfolio of interaction and attachment-seeking behaviours, even without any personal social experience. They truly are natural people pleasers. In this phase, babies demonstrate a marked preference for a human over a non-human stimuli. For example, a child of this age is much more likely to want to look at a face than at a beach ball. And straight away, they're able to exhibit these signalling behaviours, such as smiling and crying, to attach and maintain attention. Well, in the second stage, attachment in the making, it's the precursor to full-on genuine attachment. From 2 to 7 months, babies acquire the basic social rules of interacting with others, such as turn-taking and shared attention. At this stage of development, the primary caregiver is doing a huge amount of the legwork on behalf of the infant, teaching them the basic rules of play, of turn-taking and demonstrating interaction through things like baby talk conversation and playing with the baby. Bowlby's third stage is what he calls clear-cut attachment, emerging between 7 months and 2 years. Now, this stage loosely lines up with Bowlby's concept of a critical period of attachment, though this idea is somewhat out of fashion at the moment, which we're going to talk about in next time's video. By this stage, infants show undeniable indications of having formed a specific attachment. For example, it's at this point that a baby demonstrates the ability to miss their primary caregiver and doesn't treat all adults indiscriminately. It's no longer squishy baby cuddles for all, it's specific love for a specific person. The final of Bowlby's four stages is a goal-corrected partnership. And it's at this stage that the infant's behaviours from 2 years become increasingly intentional. A younger infant would cry because they're in pain, whereas an infant at this stage of development will cry in order to summon their primary caregiver. And this is a hugely sophisticated form of social interaction. Not only are they responding to their own needs and goals, but they're able to manipulate those of others by calculating primary caregiver's own personal goals into their decision-making and behaviour. And it shows that the infant has now developed the basics of a relationship. As these skills develop, a child can move beyond the initial use of external behaviours and draw on increasingly complex understandings of internal feelings and expectations. And it's at this point that Bowlby's concept of internal working models really comes into force, and the basis of all future relationships and interactions are built on these foundational interactions with a person's primary caregiver. Thank you for watching this one. If you've enjoyed it, please subscribe to the channel, give it a thumbs up to let other people know that it's a good one to watch to revise for this topic. And as always, I will see you next time for more exam-busting videos all about psychology here on Psychology Unlocked.